So I've got a real love-hate relationship with pop music, and every now and again, a song comes along that kind of just gives me hope that it's not destined for failure. And in this instance, it's Jacob Collier, featuring Lizzy McAlpine and John Mayer. I was surprised to see John Mayer on there. Seems like he just hops on up-and-coming artist songs and whacks a guitar solo out these days, which I'm all for. But Jacob Collier, for anyone who doesn't know, I didn't know him basically until this week. He's the guy that kind of has been conducting his audiences like a choir. He kind of gets them to sing in harmony, which is cool. And Lizzy McAlpine, I also found recently, who is just a beautiful like folk artist, like kind of like the next Phoebe Bridgers, I think. Those three are on this track, and it's pretty beautiful. And as I say, it has given me hope that pop music is alive, and it's quite chill. It's actually really just easy on the ears, and I think that's why I like it. I'm not a big fan of a four-to-the-floor kick drum, and this is quite musical. He seems like quite the musical guy, Jacob Collier. He's kind of like a watered-down version of Charlie Puth, but with all the musical knowledge. I don't know if I'm saying Charlie Puth correctly. I don't know if you can say it correctly in an Irish accent. But anyway, it's he's kind of like that, and he's got all this musical knowledge, and I've seen those two jamming on the piano together. He is just rejuvenating pop music. Before we get into listening to the track, if you could be ever so lovely and hit that subscribe button, I would greatly appreciate it. It sounds like if The Lion King was made today, this is how the intro would go, and the visualizer is not that different from Lion King vibes. It's really pretty actually. Are lovely.
There's a patch of sunlight in my room, on the carpet where I held you for a moment. There was something so sweet about it, never been so unguarded, and it made me fall for you.
There's a tree that looks up at the moon, in the garden where I held you for a moment. Something so sweet about it, I'm holding on to this moment, cause it made me fall for you.
When his voice enters, I mean, Lizzy McAlpine's voice is also beautiful, but when his comes in, it's kind of like this warmth just enters the song, and it's something that you can't really emulate with a plugin. It's kind of people with that voice, it's just amazing. And the way it's panned is also really nice. So he's hard pan left and right, but they've got this lovely like reverb and short plate reverb, I think. But it's panned hard left and right, and I assume there's one down the middle as well. But it just comes through like really warm, which always pleases me in songs. It's kind of like this low grumble almost, but it's just so well mixed as well.
Let me fall for you.
Take me back to the window.
And the way that Lizzy's vocal is mixed in there, I don't know if this was intentional, but it seems like she's more in the left ear and sitting like around here. For anyone who doesn't understand panning, it's basically just making it stereo and going left and right with your vocal or any instrument really. But it seems like she's really coming through this ear and only sitting about here. I don't know if that was intentional, but it's a really nice little trick. So you hear those pads swelling, which also adds to the warmth of it. And then you've got the little piano fills, which I assume that's a Jacob Collier. I haven't listened to a lot of his music, to be honest, but I assume that's something that features throughout his kind of playing. It seems like his kind of style. Guitar solo. Sorry to interrupt the guitar solo, but it seems like John Mayer has watered himself down over the years. Used to be just go crazy on the fretboard, but now he kind of just lets the song have a bit of space. This solo actually kind of reminds me of the Ed Sheeran song, is it Pain? P-A-E-N, where he does a solo on that, and it's very spacious and kind of lets the song breathe rather than just ripping at the fretboard like he would have tended to do in his early career. But I think it works perfectly for the song. Also, his manager is just firing him songs and being like, make this popular. It's not that technical. I mean, I don't know if I could play it. This is pop anymore, actually, because those kind of chord changes don't happen in pop. I don't know exactly what's going on, but it's not a four chord song, which is great. And it comes like we're 3 minutes and 8 seconds in. Well, that actually happened at about 3 minutes. And it kind of just gives the song a different like perspective. It's like, okay, I'm going to do my thing right now, and it's cool. But I'll always find my way back in. I love when songs do that, and I tend to do it a lot in my own songs, where you go back to the verse at the end, back to a verse with different lyrics maybe, at the end of the song, but they've done a nice little like guitar part at the end, which kind of just ties the song together, and that hook, take me back to the window, it happens a lot, but it's not in your face either. It's kind of just like, and I also want to say that if you were consuming the correct narcotics and watching the visualizer, the lyric visualizer thing, it could be pretty trippy. But all in all, I would say this is a lovely, fresh song, and it's just really pretty from start to finish. 4 minutes and 10 seconds, which also kind of breaks the pop trend at the moment, you could say. Like 3 minutes, 10 seconds is like ideal pop now, so it's cool that they don't really give a shit about that. Let me know what you think of the song, or Jacob Collier, or Lizzy McAlpine, but I already know all the John Mayer stuff, I'm sorry. Quite refreshing, really nice little track, and I can't wait to check out some more Jacob Collier. Thank you for watching this video, and if you enjoyed it, then please subscribe for more kind of videos like this, and let me know if there are any other Jacob Collier tracks that I should listen to. Even though I'm probably going to go down the rabbit hole now myself. Just let me know if there are any other songs in general that you think I should review, because I really enjoy doing this kind of thing. And yeah, let me know. Thanks.